only using one-third of the page. It will only let me use a third of the page, so each document is going to be 60 pages, it's now 170 pages.
I'd like to see it. Okay. Check your margins. Check and see if you've got something odd in your header and footer.
I've checked everything.
I'd be happy to look at it if it's not too confidential for me to just look at it for formatting purposes and see if we can resolve it. There is something. Have you turned on show hide?
No.
Okay, turn on show hide and see if there's anything going on in the back that's controlling it. Maybe there are page breaks because maybe the font size changed. I don't know. It's a huge difference, though.
Yeah.
It sounds very strange, so something that we could look at. All right, so PowerPoint. I don't have a, the only PowerPoint that I had right now was the one that I was playing with. So I'm going to just open that one up. Okay. And people were saying, okay, how can I make my PowerPoint interesting? Well, the one thing I did was I inserted audio here. Okay, it's an MP3. You can go out and you can find free audio clips. The way you insert audio is just on the insert ribbon and audio. And then you browse, okay, you download and then you browse just like it's an image. Okay? You can't just pick something from iTunes though. You need an MP3 and they stay embedded now. In earlier versions of PowerPoint, if you put in media, a lot of times you would lose it because of the file size because it would really be a link. It was awful and people stopped using it. Now it works pretty well.
Okay. Oh, so that's why, because I was going to ask you, because sometimes you would put, I would put that sound thing in. Mm-hmm. And then
later on, it's
later
gone.
On, you know, you see the little thing there, mm-hmm. but you don't hear
right.
the audio.
Because you were probably looking at it on a different computer.
Yeah.
Yes, that's why it was setting up that audio or video as a link, where now it's natively embedding. Okay. All right. So. Yeah. This one is 2016, but they started the embedding in 2010, possibly 2007. But I know 2010 is when the default was to try and embed. Okay. The other thing that's kind of neat, if you do have audio, you can do some little playback things like trimming the audio. Maybe you don't want the whole audio file. You can trim it back. Okay. In the same way, that works with video. If you have an MP4 video clip, you can put your video clip in. You can trim it. With the video clip, you can even set, like, the, it's called the poster image. So, the image that's on the screen when it loads, so it doesn't have somebody's face, like, you know, the beginning of the video, how sometimes it looks not so good. You can pick any image from the whole video to be that opening image.
Okay. Could you do again how you got to where you could trim?
Sure. You have to select it. It's one of those contextual tabs, right? In context. They're wonderful once you get comfortable with them. They are tabs that only show up when you need them. Staring at the little audio icon doesn't work. You have to click it right now. But visual recognition is coming. I've heard it's coming. Okay. So what I'd like to just, people were saying, how can I make my PowerPoint a little more interesting, a little more wow? You know, bullets, right? Bullets are so old and passe, but they still work. They're still effective. The important thing about bullets is that it's small amounts of text, not whole sentences. If you are going to be there during your presentation, all you need are the keywords, right? So, keywords, okay? You're going to make it brief, okay? And images are also helpful, okay? So, I'm going to say this is good. Now, I'm going to animate this. And you're like, ooh, animation sounds cheesy. You can have little dancing people. No, I'm not. Okay? I'm going to go to animations. Notice I've checked the or clicked the outside of the placeholder. There's a big difference in PowerPoint when your cursor is inside and blinking and when it's on the outer edge of the box. Okay? It may only be selecting the one word, but I want them to select all of the bullets. Okay? So if I go to animation, I'll do float in. Float in's nice. Okay? And then for effect options, by default, it's by paragraph because I use bullets. So this is what it would look like if I go to the slideshow from here. So let's talk about bullets, you know, old standard. Focus on your keywords. Focus on me and what I'm saying. You're not focusing on reading what the other bullets are till I'm ready to share it. Then I click And we talk about brevity and that sort of thing. Okay, so you can build on that topic because people cannot listen at the same time that they're reading. Please, please, please do not read to people off of your slide, okay? Because people read at a different rate that they listen. You are actually hurting their ability to absorb your content. So if you do have something up there, maybe it's a policy and it's a short paragraph and they really need to read it, it's really hard for me to do that, okay? But just be quiet and let them do it, okay? Yes?
Did you just click in order to let each word float in each time you wanted it? Is that what you did?
That's okay. The default, okay? Now, there is the animation pane, and you can do all sorts of things, where right now it is set to start on click. It can be with previous. It can be timed after previous. You can have images that come in, come out, emphasize. You can really build a whole story on one slide using animation. That takes me to something that you may not have ever seen before, but it's a wonderful tool. So I'm going to change and just use a blank layout. Please use the layouts. They're there for a reason. Okay. I know we don't like to see that click to add text, but use them. Okay. Put your text there. If you draw a text box yourself, you get rid of those placeholders and you draw a text box and you pick your font and you want to make any changes, you have to kind of select them all and they're not all lined up. Just use the placeholders. That's what they're there for. They're there to help you. They don't show up if you're not using them when you're in slideshow mode. So you're fine. But I'm going to insert a SmartArt. Okay, so SmartArt, there are lots to choose from. I'm going to choose a cycle, and I'll just choose the first one. Okay, so if you've never seen SmartArt, this is fun. I need some help here. Let's do your departments. Somebody, probably initials, right? You're like Anagram City here, right? Okay, so like, just give me some letters for a department. DCM. DSA. It doesn't matter. Oh, okay.
IRM.
The same? Huh? Some, huh?
IRM.
Okay.
DSSC.
DSSC.
LTCOP.
Love it. Okay, wonderful. So we can say that you're all interconnected some way. When I have this, oops, I just jiggled it out of place. Now that I have this selected, I can go to animations. Guess what? I can have things fade in one by one. That building on a story idea? Okay. Once I have it selected, I can also change colors. Where is that? So if you don't like all blue, you can do full color, right? You can just play around. It's based on your theme. So if you change your theme, if you go to your design and you change and you choose a different theme, your colors will update. Okay. All right. These are also automatically on a click, but you can have them timed. You can also, no offense against the department I'm blipping out here. I just want to show you that you can also format the shape and change the fill to a picture. So if I go to a file, oh, that's right. I don't have any good pictures on this computer. It's like me. It's an awful picture of me. Okay, so there I am. All right. Now that that picture tool is on, I could crop that, and obviously it was squishing it to fit in there. So I can crop my picture down. My hand-eye coordination is bad. But it's a really bad picture of me anyway. Look, I think I'm even sticking out my tongue. Okay. Oh, I put it, there we go. All right, so that's a little more as far as, there we go. Oh, I'm just got a frowny face. Okay, so when I take the crop off, you can see there it is. My picture was still too short, so I make it bigger. So this crop tool, if you haven't used crop, okay, it's wonderful. It gets rid of that creeper person on the edge that you don't want, okay? It helps you get down. I'm sorry, that looks terrible. And this is being recorded. Oh, that's horrible. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I am going to say that you can also fill it with a pattern or a texture. Okay, so I'll pick a picture, a pattern, and I'll just fill it with that. All right. But the idea that you can use images, you can make it more interesting. You can make it more meaningful. Okay. Great. How am I doing on time? I have 5 more minutes in PowerPoint. We are going to come back to PowerPoint because somebody said graphs, Excel graphs are very interesting. Guess what? You can animate a graph in PowerPoint, and it looks great, and it's really easy. So I will come back to PowerPoint. I reserve that option to come back. Okay? And a new slide. Okay? So, any questions before I move on to Excel? Yes?
Is this also on your website?
Well, not all of this. I mean, I'm recording this session, so you can play me back as many times as you want, and you'll be able to see what's going on up here.
How would I do that?
Where the video will be up there, and you can scrub through the video and rewatch me as many times as you want. I even have a YouTube channel. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can fill out my contact form and ask me questions, and I usually make a video answer because it's just as quick as trying to write back a lengthy email. Okay? So, but great question. Any other questions about PowerPoint? Oh, one other thing about PowerPoint that people don't use, and it's such a good tool, is the notes pane. Okay? So, put your notes here. Okay? These can be the presenter notes if you're in presenter view, but what's even greater, remember I said try and limit the amount of text on the slides, but then everybody says, can I have your PowerPoint? Right? And it's like, well, sure, but the whole idea was that you were there and you were engaged in the moment, and okay, but I'll make it as a help file afterwards. Fine. So if you can put copious notes. I hope I spell copious right. Copious notes, okay? Copious. I don't know. I don't have spell check down here. But you go to the file menu, all right? And we all know about printing with the little notes line. No, okay? What I want you to do is go to export and create real handouts, okay?
Why do you say no?
Because they don't get your notes that way. They just get a place to write, okay? So I'm going to have the notes that I left in my PowerPoint show up, that it becomes a real handout, a PDF I can give to them electronically, or I could print it if they really wanted it. But what's nice is it sends it to Word. Okay? Once it's in Word, look at this. It's a table. I find that that slide number is pretty useless, so I just delete that column, right? And then this would be anything in the notes pane on any of the slides. Then you can put on page numbering, you can put on a nice little header and footer, you can do whatever you want, and you've got like a really sharp looking handout. Okay?
I can go back
to PowerPoint? Yes.
File and then...
Oh, sure. So it's file, export,
okay.
And create handouts.
Okay.
Now, what's the difference between that and then file and showing like slides per page?
Because the 3 slides per page don't provide your notes, they provide a place for note taking.
Okay.
They provide lines for the viewer that was live in the room to take their own notes. Well, I get a lot, I missed your session, can I have your notes? By the way, I guess I didn't really introduce myself very well except that I'm Sandy McVeigh, Delaware native, youngest of 6, mom of 5, work at the University of Delaware, educational technology consultant. I work with faculty in technology. I also teach for New Castle County adult activities on Saturday morning at Garfield Park. I love working with adult learners. Love it. Okay. So thank you again for all being here. Any other questions about this before we move into Excel? Yes.
Sorry. The ribbon up at the top, I guess, Word, is it the same on all computers?
It is similar. Now, as I said, I'm using Office 2016, okay? But Office 2013 and Office 2010, I know someone wrote a specific question in the survey that they wanted to know the differences between 2010 and 2013. They're very minor. I could provide a link to an article, or you can Google, that I know that you don't have full access here at work. But we're all voracious learners. Just go out and Google it, and it's there. Okay? Yes?
In PowerPoint, if I have a JPEG or something in the graphic,
sure.
And I want to change the color in the graphic, which software do you use for that?
I use PowerPoint for that. Oh no, let's see. Okay, so, oh, I'm gonna have to go back to the same horrible. Okay, here's a different picture. That's still pretty bad. Okay, so if you have a picture in here, I was showing people my ID card at the university to show them, you know, where they're, there are new UD1 numbers. So when you have this in, okay, in PowerPoint, there are a lot of things you could do. Okay, so there you can work on the contrast and things like that, but you can also recolor. So it works a little better with JPEGs off of the search from Bing, which I don't have access to on this computer because I don't have access to the internet. You can also set a transparent color. Gosh, I wish I had a sample of that. You know, when you have the picture of that dog, but it has a white background, okay, and you want that background to go away, the transparent color will let you get rid of one color. Okay, so it's not one color tone, it's really one color. So if I click very close on the, yeah, let's try it again. Let's try and find some color that it's going to read at. See, it's just too much color variation. Okay, so I'm sorry I don't have a good image for that. But it'll take away the background. Also on images, there is, well, let me bring that back again. The other image editor, you can do remove background, and that helps you get rid of things that maybe, you can see this, if I say keep changes, it gets rid of most of all the background. If I wanted to get rid of the rest of that blue, I could go in here and I could say mark areas to remove and say get rid of this too. Okay. So there's a lot of editing you can do in PowerPoint now. And I would say, you know, play with those color tones because they work well. Did that help at all?
Is there another program that doesn't work?
I go right to Photoshop. I don't have an interim one. I'm sorry. Okay. I will say the bulk of what I do, I can do in PowerPoint. But then after that, I skip right to Photoshop. I don't have an interim. Anybody else that they have a photo editing program?
If you remove the color from the background, mm-hmm. and you want to change the color, can you do that?
No, you can't substitute a color. Sorry. Okay. You could insert like a shape behind it. Okay, so there's a shape. And we'll pick a different color that looks, oh, I'm in some design palette that's really, really earthy toned, right? So I want to choose a different color palette that has more color variation. Fine. Okay. By the way, that's a really nice way to update and just make yours look slightly different from someone else's. You pick one of the standard designs and then you just can change the color palette. That works really well when you do a lot of presentations and you're never quite sure how the projector is going to translate what your screen is showing versus what it shows. So I can see this is really, really pink up here, even though it's not so pink on mine. So I'll go with this color. Okay. I have to bring that stinking picture back. I'm sorry. I'll bring back this one. So if I wanted to, hey, I can crop, remember. Cropping is such a wonderful tool to get rid of this extra stuff. Okay. I'll just get rid of that. Okay. And, oh, let's make this a different color because blue and blue isn't going to give you much variation, is it? Okay. So let's see if I can get some transparency on the blue.